Hello, King of Iron here, and I am back for one particular reason. It's been a long time since I've made any videos since somewhere around August, I guess. I made that last PSP video until the next one was Lil Miku running her dog for like 2 minutes. That was that last video. This time I'm going to be making a comparing video, a difference video. I'm not going to be making any tutorials right now because I'm not in a mood. I have no idea which tutorial I should make, but I come up with this little idea. This idea is for those people who say that 69 Charger, 1969 Charger was basically used in Fast and Furious. Now, I'm going to be making this a video on this particular topic. So let's get started. I'm going to tell you first how 69 Charger really looks. Okay, let's see. You can barely tell that it's almost like 68 Charger. But what's the difference you see is that this middle thing is in its front grille, which is making it more cooler. Whereas in the back, those two LED lights are removed and use this simple clean looking rear lights to make it even more better, and RT in the middle, which is quite good and really good. Now if you look at the 70 chart in the Fast and Furious, you can barely tell that it is the Fast and Furious movie, but how can you tell that it's a 69 Charger? Well, there are basically two reasons behind this. First, if you look at the door, it's from 69 Charger's model. The reason why it's from 69 Charger is to make this one look much better. Whereas in the back, it's also the 69 Charger's rear lights. But the point is that there's no RT at the back to make it more like monstrous or making it more fearsome looking machine. And anyway, yeah, these are the two main reasons why people say that 69 Charger was used. A long time ago, I asked my cousin that a 70 Charger was actually used in the Fast and Furious movie. But what he told me that go to Google Images and type 69 Charger Fast and Furious, and the one that I showed you just came. And he was like, haha, I win. No, this isn't the right car. So, I'm gonna making a comparing video, but let's look at the 70 Charger. You can barely tell that it is from the Fast and Furious movie, but most people reject it. I don't know the reason why, but they say that it is not the Fast and Furious, but that's not used in Fast and Furious movie. You can tell it by the door. Now this time the door is completely different from the 69. It's looking like trying to make it as an aircraft model in a way, I guess. I suggest. And it has a leather hard top, which is more boring. While in the 69 there is available in hard in that one, but commonly used as leather hard top, which is not good. Alright, now let's take the comparisons of the rear lights of a 70 Charger and the 69 Charger. The 70 Charger is so ugly that the person would directly vomit, while in the 69 it's like, oh yeah, for beauty. Now, they chose a 70 Charger, but they also tuned it because 69 is looking better than the 71. The 70, however, isn't so good. It's just too much. I mean, it's not so good. It's not good looking. It's just, you know, it's as if it's like Uncle Charger or something in a way. It's so boring, so ugly, while the 69 is so good. That's why they kept a 69 rear light on this model. And yeah, so basically you can see the difference. Now let's take a little more look at the 70 from Fast and Furious. This is the Fast and Furious 4 Charger, which was used, and it has, let me see, 18 or 19 inch rims. The PS1 had like 16 or 15. This has a longer, bigger rims than the previous one, and has a matte black color, and has a smaller blower than the previous one, which is still good, not that bad. So anyway, yeah, this Now, this is the profile view of this 70 charger from the Fast and Furious. The 69 door, the 69 charger's door, and that's probably it. You can see from this particular view. The hood, however, is common in all chargers you see, and except for the front, this front grille is different. Or you can see the RT, a little small RT on the left side of the charger, and yeah, that's it. Well, anyway, now let's take a comparison between the 69 charger and the Fast and Furious 70 charger. You can tell the difference. This time you are completely, you know, like, hey, how can this be? I thought it was 69 charger. Hey, no, stop. Now you can see the difference. You can see the front of these both chargers. They are completely different. The 70 charger, however, is looking more better than the 69 version. If you still don't believe me, take a look at this picture. You can tell the difference now. Which version of charger is better, the 69 version or the 70 version? You can tell the difference. If you color this 69 version in a black matte and removing these hideaway headlights cover thingy, then how it will look? It will look, I don't know, something more boring than the 70. I do like 70s because people mostly just suggest that 69 and 68 are better than the 70. It's because they're more common, they're more popular. 70 is draining out from the world. It's best that you get one, restore it, and there you go, your beauty monster than the 69. However, the 70 version does not include a 440, while the 69 does, which is down for the 70 but up for the 69. So let's take more pictures view from the 70 charger from Fast and Furious. It's looking so good. It's looking really good, in fact, that 69 is not strong enough to face it. You can tell, as if it's like modern chargers, today's charger, the present one. It's so good. But for the 69, I don't really suggest that should be in the Fast and Furious movie. But there's one problem. In most games of Fast and Furious, let's take the Tokyo Drift one, there was a 69 charger in it. Midnight Club, 69 charger was also used on this. They say that 69 charger was used in Fast and Furious, so why not be used for something else? That's why 70 charger was not so common in any other places, while 69 and 68 was, which is sad for the 70. And mostly people around the world will be like, hey, 69 charger was used in FNM, duh. No, still no. I made this comparing video for you guys that 69 charger was not used in Fast and Furious. I told the comparison, I made the comparison pictures, blah blah blah. So this probably it for you guys. Note, and yep, this is it. 70 charger for the last time is used in Fast and Furious. There you go. Excuse me. And what seems else to be left? I don't know. Maybe take a look at this picture again. And this time it's black, the leather hard top. And the stock version has this line cutting through the grill, which is making it more, more ugly, more aggressively? No, I don't think so. But I do note that the 70 charger is better than any other charger that exists. Even further than this, like 71, 72, 73, they're all boring. They are cheaper because they are more commonly used than the 69. Where am I getting to anyway? Well, yeah, this is it. I hope you understand the logic of mine. I hope you understand it. Thanks for watching. If you still have some suggestion about this car, please comment down in the video. And yeah, this is it. Thanks for watching. See you next time. God, this is the worst video ever.